Hello, pilots, and welcome to the World of Pain, which means the next episode, How to Play. Today, an unusual guest for me. I only hunt for them for the last few years, but being tempted by 30% discount, I just buy myself RB-17, legendary bomber in our game. But yes, history first. RB-17 remained only as a project in design office of Major General of Engineering, Hero of Social Labor, Doctor of Technical Sciences, Vladimir Mikhailovich Myasishchev. The design started during the war and the project was very promising. It was an attempt to use the captured German engines because, as you know or may not know, USSR did not have jet engines at the time. But right after the war, a major reorganization of aviation industry began. So in February 1946, the work on RB-17 project was stopped. Most of the designers and engineers were transferred to the Ilyushin Design Bureau, and the development for RB-17 jet bomber were also transferred then. And thanks to that, experimental IL-22 was soon built, as you can see on the picture right now. And I will leave the link in the description to the page with interesting facts about this project for history fans, of course. The bomber has been in the game for a long time and once was for sure undisputed king. Like, the question is whether it's still good and worth buy or not. Let's check it out.
A few moments later.
And everything changed when the Fire Nation attacked.
Thank you.
and shower after each bombing mission. However, I tried to make a 5-chevron battle for a very long time, and finally I made it, but before we get into it, let's say a few words about this machine and other bombers on this tier as well. We have 4 bombers in tier 8. B-29 we can skip it, because most of the player will actually agree with me that this is completely overpowered premium plane. The number of bombs and defenses weapons are deadly, and the only chance for other bombers is speed. B-29 is much slower than other bombers. This is the only weak point that we can use like in advantage. Then if we look at 3 other bombers, the RB-17 is the fastest and also has the largest bomb load, except of course B-29, but we cannot throw the bombs one by one like other bombers from the line. We have 3 drops of 6 bombs, total 18, and this creates actually the problem of quick capturing sectors. When we have ability to destroy a maximum of 3 objects in a sector, this is like not enough, and to overcome this, attacks on sectors must be mastered to perfection, basically. And so attacking the factory and taking over by yourself with one bomb load is actually possible, even if the factory is hostile. 180 points. We destroy the main building with one package of bombs at high speed to spread the bombs over the entire object. We have 80 points, and then we destroy buildings worth 50 points with 2 remaining packages of bombs. There are always 2 such sites with 50 points on each factory. So it is very difficult but possible. When it comes to other sectors, unfortunately it is impossible to take them over with one bomb load. To help, we can use our speed and powerful tail gunner and his range, of course. Unlike the bots in-game, defense planes do not let go attack, so it is easier to finish them off with tail gunner. And that gives us extra 40 points for each plane. That can be helpful, but for example, in case of a rocket base, we can maximum points we can get from one bomb load is 120. So it's not even enough to flip over the neutral rocket base. We will have to actually use our tail gunner and take out one of the heavy fighter which is there to flip over. And that's not very easy, specifically if that's gonna be the enemy rocket base, that actually wouldn't be enough to take out the fighter. There are 2 fighters on each rocket base, and we would have to take 2 heavy fighters with tail gunner in order to flip over the enemy rocket base. So I would say it's easier to wait, reload the bombs and attack some AA defenses or whatever left there to flip it over, because it's gonna be easier than fighting with the heavy fighters. Now, to quickly flip over the command center when it's neutral, we need to destroy 2 buildings which give us 30 points each. I just aimed them now, and one in the middle in the center for 50 points with this big round dish, and plus that will give us like 110 points, which is still not enough, right? Because neutral command center have 140 points, so we have to take out at least one of this light fighter with tail gunner to flip over the neutral command center. But if it's the enemy one, like red, then we have to shut down 2 of these planes, so it's pretty difficult. I just managed to destroy one of this building with bombs, another one survived, but I was actually able to shut down 2 of these light fighters. So it is difficult, definitely difficult, but in order to have good results, we really need to train this, as I do in here on this video. That's actually training room when I train this, flipping over this zone as quick as possible. One bomb load and main building done, yes. So I make one mistake here, I didn't manage to destroy one of this building for 30 points. Our survivability is actually combined with our tail gunner. Now he have a 1000 meter range that can be increased with equipment, and this range is much more than other planes from tech tree. Such a range combined with our speed and HP gives us a good chance of defend ourselves against any opponent, if you of course notice the threat early enough to get the gunner and give the top speed as well. Now, let's get into the battle with 5 Chevron. I know what you're thinking. How the hell that was a 5 Chevron battle? Well, I tell you what, I was surprised too. We'll be right back. This is what I call in the last moment. The game didn't even catch up with this result immediately. So let's sum up everything. It's still a very good bomber. Not the only one premium anymore, but still good. In the promotion we can buy it quite cheap, and this guy actually earned incredibly well, like RB-17 earned a lot of credits for us. Silver, if you prefer. Require good skill from the bomber pilot. I didn't want to say skill, because what kind of skill is that? To press spacebar through the battle? No, that's a joke. Relax. No offense, bomber pilots, come on. A lot of fun from playing, and I recommend it for bomber fans, and specifically in promotion, it's worth to buy it. Give you a lot of win and great results. Like, despite this, that to make the 5 chevron battle is rather rare, but still it's very good and fun to play. So we're in the end of the video. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoy it. Please subscribe and leave a like if you like it, and see you in next one. Take care, guys.